It is the third week of this season, and you know when it's week three, we have old friend Steve Wright, day one, the champs of the defending neighborhood league champions, the Bullets. Back in the day, buddy. Open up that can. Welcome you all to another edition of Around the Rim, hashtag ATR. I am your host, the Dudster, Nesta Dudley, and I present to you in his first public appearance in 2019, the head coach of your defending neighborhood league champs, Bullets, Steve Wright. Welcome back again, brother, to Around the Rim.
Always a pleasure, Nesta. This is where I want to make my first appearance this year.
I am so honored that we got to see you first on this show. I mean, very uncharacteristic of you to miss opening weekend. You missed three games.
Yeah,
three games.
Yeah, I was sick the first weekend. First time I ever missed opening weekend. First time in ever. So, and the next weekend, we're down to one car, and my two sons had games on Saturday, so
your
I couldn't make
your two sons are playing basketball.
They're both playing basketball.
Shout them out. What's their names?
Connor and Logan. And they're both playing. And my little girl who's sick at home, she got what I got. Yeah. My little girl, McKenna. So, So they're both playing, so I can't retire for another 7 years.
Okay.
I got to stick around seven more years.
Is it true? Is there any truth to the rumor that BD Amos has claims on your son if he decides to play in the Mall Neighborhood Basketball League?
If it was up to my wife, it would be. she don't want him to play for me. She thinks I'll be too tough on them. You know what I mean? But I guess that's from going to their games and shouting down from the stands, baby.
Now, you just said that you were sick opening weekend, and I had the commissioner on the show last week, Commissioner Ken Mazonson. And I know that you're sitting home and Drake is streaming the show, and if you don't want to stream, which I know you and the kinfolks down in the Kakalakis, you Kakalaki kinfolks, you listen to me now, go to YouTube, Nesta Dudley, hashtag Around the Rim, and you can catch it live. Subscribe. Make sure you click. Have you gone to YouTube?
Yes,
and hit that, and you've hit that subscribe button?
Yes.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing. Now, as I was saying, you were sick that first weekend. Your season opener was against the Lakers. You probably thought you had it in the bag, because the week before in the Jamboree, your Bullets were just destroyed the Lakers. So when you got the news that the Lakers won, and me and Ken Mazonson was just wondering, if the Lakers beat the Bullets and Steve Wright is not in the house, does that game actually count? Is that actually your sanctioned game?
It counts because I was over the toilet throwing up.
You went straight for the bath bucket. I think no one was more surprised than Beattie.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think we only had five kids there.
I think it was like 5-on-5, yes. It was. It's always so tough the opening weekend. The uniforms are being given out. The fees, not all the fees have been paid yet. And we certainly don't understand why the fees have not. What's that? Crackling? This is live time. They said that your audio is crackling. So we ready?
I had the mic the right way.
We'd rather get this audio right down now. How about now?
Hello?
Sounds better? Right. Okay. This is live television and we can do this. And I've learned that from watching longtime live host Ron Cox live on tape. So we can do this. Ain't that right? Right? Oh, okay. Well, we're gonna tend to that. But I lost my train of thought.
Yeah, we were talking about.
The fees. And your kiddies out there, we have a system in place where you just have to do a little effort, sell the raffles, and everyone's able to play. We have a system where you don't have to take $1 out of your pocket. So, yes, yeah, so both teams had 5-on-5.
Oh, okay.
So the numbers were there. There was no substitution whatsoever. The only thing that wasn't fair was the Bullets losing, I guess.
We always have battles, though, with the Lakers. I mean, it's always, you never know which way it's going to go. You know, and like I said before, the Bullets have been bad and the Lakers have been good and the Bullets have beaten them. The Lakers have been bad and the Bullets have been good and the Lakers beat them. It's always a good rivalry. It's the oldest rivalry in the MNBL. So, I mean, it's, you know, you just never know how, but it's always a battle. You know, there's usually not many blowouts. It's usually always a battle. So, you know, we play them again. I'll be there for that one.
And you can tell the Bullet history.
That's right. I can tell my speech.
Down your Bullet roster, and this is the latest roster I have, so if there's any changes, please let me know. Bill Chen, Jordan Kelly, Gustavo Silva, Antonio Jonahtan, Mark Henley Noel, Joan Harrell May, and I apologize if I butchered that name, Burton Dovier, Nico Soares, Matt Millen. You guys really look good, really look real good in the Jamboree. And last weekend, however I missed your game, more of the players showed up and you got your first victory over the Hawks.
Yeah, I think when we're, Gustavo is not playing this year for some reason. I've never seen him. Okay. And he's never contacted even on the text.
Okay.
But so we're down to 8 guys and it's tough because if you miss one or two, you're already down to 6.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
And it's when we have a full team, we have 3 really good returning players. So we have a 3 good veterans, which is really good. And then.
And the vets are?
Mark Noel Henry.
Mm-hmm.
We have Antonio.
Jonahtan.
Jonahtan. Yeah. And.
Bill Chen?
Bill Chen. Now, Bill Chen hasn't been there much either because of chess. I guess he's becoming a grandmaster.
Oh, okay.
So,
well,
I mean, that's why he wasn't there at the championship last year. He had a big tournament
Wow.
for school,
Wow.
for the school. So he goes to Malden Catholics. But, yeah, so I don't know how much I'm going to have him this year, but we really need him. Really need those 3 veterans to be there all the time because they know our system, the stability, and they could take the – we have a young team.
Mm-hmm.
Because 2 of those veterans still have another year.
Okay.
They're only juniors. Only Bill Chen is a senior. So, and they could take the young kids and, you know, really mold them and adapt to our system. So it's tough. We have everybody there. Me, personally, I think we're a pretty good team.
Well, in the first show, I said that the Bulls were going.
I saw that.
I also
watched the whole thing.
I also used my right to rescind it.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to insinuate anything,
yeah.
But I did have the bullet. But I did have the Bullets going.
Yeah. I mean, it's just. I think it's going to take to the second half of the season, and I think if everybody shows up for practices, I had to cancel practice tonight because I had many kids cancel because of midterms.
Oh.
They're studying for midterms, but if I can get guys to practice and to the games, the second half I think will be one of the toughest teams to play.
Now, being the defending Neighborhood League champs, you know that there is a target on your team. Rightfully
so.
Yeah. Everybody wants to take out the champs.
Yeah, I mean, you know, that's the way it should be. You know, I mean, even I feel that way when you're playing a defending champion. You know, you want to beat them. So, yeah, I mean, that's. And I understand that, and we're going to take our lumps. I'm just hoping the second half we're a lot better. And I'm hoping to try to sneak into that fourth spot. But the schedule's not favorable. The
first, you know, how many times have you been on this show and we talked about the schedule?
Yeah. It's true. It's like we're playing the Kings back-to-back weekends. And we haven't even played some teams once yet. It just doesn't make sense. And I say.
Is that back-to-back weekend coming up soon?
Yeah, this weekend.
Oh, this weekend.
We have 1 game this weekend. We're playing the Kings. And then the next weekend, we have 2 games. We're playing the Kings. And they're a good team.
They are a good team.
So, I mean, that could be, that's possible for two losses. You know what I mean? So that, you know, that really hurts.
Or two victories.
Or two victories. Yeah. I'll be happy with the split.
I was just going to say, I'm sure that you wouldn't be mad at a 500.
No. No, you never know. You know, anything can happen down the MNBL.
Anything can happen. Yeah. Speaking of anything happening, we are in that segment caught up in the MNBL web. Ooh. And I see that your glasses are fogging up right
They're
now.
Fogging.
And what this segment and caught up in the MNBL web is that I have up into 3 minutes to ask my guest, in this case, the head coach for the defending neighborhood league champs, Steve Wright, anything that I would like, and it may or may not have to do with the Marvin Neighborhood Basketball League. This question does have to do with basketball, doesn't have to do with the MNBL, but it does have to do with a couple of rights that we talked about earlier in the show. Now that your boys are playing basketball, and they're playing basketball up in Drakehead,
yes,
you are split now, because you got your boys are your boys and your offsprings, and you love them.
Yeah.
But you've had the Bullets since day one. Uh-huh. How do you, you can't be in two places at once, at least not on this planet.
No, it's not easy. And these are the years, really, that I want to see my kids play. I mean, for, you want to say for 30 years, you know, I've been coaching other kids, you know, other people's kids.
And this league is 34 years old, and you've been here every day.
Yeah, all
every
34.
Moment of it, yes.
So, I mean, even baseball I did for 26. And all those years, you know, coaching other people's kids. And now my kids are finally playing. And I don't want to coach them down in Drakehead.
Right.
But I will in the MNBL. But I want to watch them.
Right.
You know, I want to watch what they can do and what they don't like it after the game, because I tell them everything they need to change. But
right.
They don't listen to me.
Right.
It's like...
Well, if they did play the Marvin Neighborhood Basketball yeah. League, you could watch them play for the Lakers.
Yeah. Well, the Kings are trying to get them, too. I, you know, I didn't have the bag. I was at practice by myself the other week, so I didn't have the bag. Mark was away on vacation, and Eric was sick. And I had a ball. I sent my oldest son to go over and borrow a ball from the Kings, and he wouldn't give him the ball unless he signed an MNBL contract to play for the Kings. So, I mean, I guess that's an advantage of being 12 years old and being almost as tall as me. I guess that's an advantage.
Didn't you get Mark Gagnon into the Wright family under similar circumstances?
Well, I made him sign a blank piece of paper so I could always hold it over him, just in case.
And how old was he?
He was probably underage, but I won't say that. I'll say he was 18.
Steve Wright, you are officially out of the web. Right back in the studios of Malden Access Television, around the rim, ATR. I'm your host, the Nesta Dudley, here with head coach of the defending neighborhood league champs, the Bullets. And are there any early challenges that you see being in the defending neighborhood league champ and you not being there full time, because you have to split your time? Now, you have two capable assistants, yeah. Mark Gagnon, Eric Ribeiro, very capable. They know the system. Gagnon's a Bullet. Ribeiro played as a Sixer, but he is a Bullet.
Yeah.
So that's on lock. But what are the challenges?
It is a lot of challenges, because you want to be there. And when you've got a young team and you've got young kids, you want to get to know them. Because I try to find out, know a lot more too. I like to know what's going on with their school life, what's going on with their personal. I mean, I really try to get to know them. So, and that's why I say once a Bullet, always a Bullet. You know, so I always try to, even though I got two great coaches, I couldn't ask for better coaches. I've had Mark since he was 12 when he played for me in baseball. And basketball, I mean, I had
and possibly when he signed that contract, but we're not going to mention that.
That contract, 18 he was. But yeah, so, I mean, there's a lot of challenge. I want to be there. I want to be able to coach them. I want to see their strengths. I want to see their weaknesses. I mean, it makes a lot, because even though I get the coaches, I'm the one making the final decision. And, you want to be there on the court. I miss it because I still get hyped up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, from the start of the season to the end of the season. I mean, and we've had some great kids, fantastic kids. the past few seasons. It's really made it enjoyable. And so it's hard not being there. I mean, there is a lot of challenges, but, you know, hopefully here going forward, I can make some more.
Now, I don't know if you are aware of this, but at Ref Rob Tuttle has pointed this out to me moments before we gone on live, that your coaches that we were just talking about, Gagnon and Ribeiro, they are leaving timeouts in that book. They're not using up all those timeouts.
That can't be the case. I thought I taught them well. You have to use every time, even if you don't need them.
They're leaving them on the board.
Oh, yeah, that's ridiculous. We'll change that Sunday because I'll be there Sunday.
You'll show them how it's done. So as you said, that you have the Kings this Sunday, the Kings 2-1. There's a bunch of teams that are 2-1. And the Kings, I predicted the Kings to take the whole doggone thing. What challenges that you would, well, what challenges do the Kings propose? Let me get their roster right here. I normally have these rosters right up front. Mohammed Aishat Cherif, Salim Tekin, Fernando Pedro, Jeffrey Song, Jaden Brito White, Adam Chen, Roberto Belton, Dominic Bono, Jason Chan, Woody Raphael. What are the challenges? That team's solid.
I saw them in the Jamboree, and they looked really good. You know, and I haven't seen them since because I haven't been there. But they really looked like a good rebounding team, a good shooting team, a team that could take it to the basket. I mean, and especially for a young team like us, we're not ready to play a team like them yet. You know, I know we've had some success with the Kings, but that's all out the window because they're not ready. And when we're playing back-to-back, I mean, I was hoping to play them a little more, you know, first soon and then near the end of the season. But when you have a young team, it takes so long. I mean, we only had 3 returners. You got all new players. It's hard to get them ready. That's why I always tell them it's going to be at least 6, 7, 8 games before you even know each other, before you know your strengths and weaknesses. So hopefully we can, play them a good battle. Hopefully everybody will show up Sunday and at least we can give them maybe a chance.
Taking my cue from at Ref Rob Tuttle, we're going to go to last weekend's games and scores. So last weekend, the week of January 12th, first game, Kings, Pistons. Pistons 7 points better than Kings, 58-51. Cherif, high man for the Kings, 18 points. Niboh led all scores with 24 points as the Pistons improved to 1-0. The Kings dropped to, 1-1. The Kings dropped to 1-1. Next game, Hawks, Bullets. Bullets, 14 points better than the Hawks, 48-34. Dovier, high man for the Bullets, 12 points. Gomez led all scores with 16 points as the Bullets improved to 1-2. Hawks dropped to 0-3. Third game Saturday, Sonics, Sixers. Sonics 45, Sixers 37. Lopes, high man for the Sixers, 10 points. Philippe led all scores with 19 points as the Sonics improved to 2-0. Sixers dropped to 0-2. First game Sunday, Kings, Sonics. Kings 47, Sonics 34. Tyken, high man for the Kings, 14 points. Serrano led all scores with 18 points as the Kings improved to 2-1. The Sonics dropped to 2-1. Second game, Lakers, Celtics. Celtics 7 points better than the Lakers, 38-31. Kelly, high man for the Celtics, 13 points. Bridgman Dix led all scores with 14 points as the Celtics improved, staying on top of the land, 3-0. The Lakers dropped to 2-1. The third and final game, Sunday, Pistons 58, Sixers 53. Stringer, high man for the Pistons, 19 points. St. Jean led all scores with 25 points as the Pistons improved to 2-1 and the Sixers dropped to 0-3. And that's how it all went down in this past weekend's play. And now for the weekly Around the Rim Awards. So let's kick it! Player of the Week, Mark Niboh of those Pistons. Coach of the Week, Marcus Bailey of the Pistons. Team of the Week, the Pistons. Steve, is this going to be a Pistons sweep? Wooo of the Week. Wooo of the Week, no, Pistons sweep. Wooo of the Week goes to Jonahtan Cesar, Yemen Jalal, Darius Philippe, and Joshua Serrano of the Sonics. Why those four gentlemen Again, shout it out for Wooo of the Week and Jazzy Joseph. You can take that slate down. Why those four gentlemen? Because, Steve, I don't know if you know this, but this is the first time that this has ever happened. The Sonics played the Sixers last Saturday. The Sonics had four guys, and the MNBL coaches put in the rule books, put in the bylaws, last year or two seasons ago, that you can start with four. Four on five, and they beat them. Four on five.
The whole game?
The whole
game.
No one else came. Four on five.
That's pretty good.
And I missed the majority of the game. Yeah. Now, Team Mama Liz came right up to me and said, Nesta, I watched your show for years. Ever since my hubby was playing, he played for the Sonics, you know that. Yeah. And this, if this is not deserving of Wooo of the Week, there's nothing is. So I listen to Mama Liz. So you Sonics, this collective Wooo is for all four of you. Wooo! And now on to the weekly standings. If it doesn't look like this, it just ain't official. The Celtics on top of the land, 3-0, perfect. Followed by the Lakers, the Pistons, the Kings, and the Sonics. It's a 2-1 bunch up. Bullets, the defending neighborhood league champs, 1-2. The Sixers and the Hawks bringing up the rear, zip in 3. This weekend's games coming up. Saturday, January 19th, the first game, Hawks versus the Pistons. Second game, Celtics versus the Sonics. Third game, Lakers versus the Sixers. And in that second game, hashtag fill in the green. Sunday's game, the 20th, first game, Bullets Kings. Second game, Sixers Hawks. And the third game, Lakers Sonics. And that second game, hashtag moving on up. One of them teams will be moving on up. Where to read them every week in the Marlin Advocate. The paper is free for the cheap, cheap, cheap. As for the website for the Marlin Neighborhood Basketball League, it's currently under construction. But you can follow the Marlin Neighborhood Basketball League. There goes Jazzy Josie going by those slates again. You can follow the Marlin Neighborhood Basketball League on Instagrams at MNBL1986 or the online home of this show, ATRLive.com. Around the Rim, when to watch them? Every Thursday live, Comcast Channel 3, Verizon Channel 28. It repeats the next Friday at 10 p.m., followed by the following Wednesday at 3 p.m. in the afternoon. And, of course, this is all on MATV, Malden's Media Center. Like and stream on Facebook, Around the Rim, hashtag follow, hashtag stream, hashtag retweet, at Nesta Dudley on Twitter or at the real Nesta Dudley on Instagram. Because, Steve Wright, there's only one real Nesta Dudley.
Only one.
The only one. Moving forward, you can stream ATR on all devices, live or VOD, at ATRLive.com. That is the website. And subscribe to our YouTube channel, Around the Rim. Subscribe, please. Our goal this year is to try to get 100 subscribers, and we got a couple subscribers before this show started. So we are only 52 subscribers away from 100 subscribers. Nesta Dudley on YouTube. My mic sounds nice. Check one. I said my microphone sounds nice when it's on. Check two. Beyond the Rim, the podcast, is the other venture that the Dudster does. And we talk about anything under the sun, whether it's pop culture, politics, comic books, fake news, as myself and Steve Wright was talking about right before the show started. You all can be streamed on Beyond the Rim. Beyond the Rim, available wherever you get your podcasts. It's also available on iTunes. You can download it at the website, btrmic.com, or you can go subscribe to it on that same YouTube page. And we're doing really good on time, Steve. We got just north of 5 minutes, to go. So are there any shout-outs? Because it seems like we get into these long conversations and then we short shrift a shout-out. Let's get the shout-outs out of the way now.
Well, let me give a shout-out to Steve Frecker, who I saw right out here as I'm walking in. I haven't seen him forever.
Steve Frecker, old friend of the show.
Yeah, who used to coach the Hawks. We got to say hi to the Cackalackers up in,
the kinfolk down the Cackalackers.
my mother and father-in-law, they're watching.
Let's get off this shot. And I'm playing wrong clocks now. Let's go off the shot. There we go.
And my wife and kids who are at home, so hello. And the Grassi girls, I haven't mentioned them in a long time. So, and my coaches and players, hopefully everybody's watching. Oh, no, not my players. They're studying. Midterms.
Yeah,
midterms.
That's right. They better be studying and cancel practice.
And I want to thank everybody here who does a great job on the show, you know, and they just bring a great show every week. So.
As you know, it's certainly not easy to produce the show. It's live weekly. We have volunteers. We have volunteers that have been here for a long time. We even have the executive director right on, Ron, who would jump in and volunteer. So yeah, just to make this happen.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I mean, you guys do a great job, and it's nice that you have all these people to help you, you know, and that's terrific. So great job. I enjoy coming every year.
Now back to the Bullets. Well, I have not seen that classic traditional Bullets half court offense. Haven't seen it.
No, but you will. I mean, like I said, the second half, I'm hoping that guys start coming to practice and start coming to the games that, you know, I think with the full squad, all eight of them, I really do think we'll be a team to reckon with the second half. Hopefully we can win enough in the first half until we really start rolling, you know. So at least we got our first win. They got a little taste of it, and then we'll see what happens.
With an eight-man squad, and we know basketball is an exhausting game and it's a physical game, and so with an eight-man squad, that means you only have three fresh legs that you can rotate in during the course of the game.
Yeah, it's tough. I'd rather have like 11 or 12 than have eight or nine.
I think you're in the minority of that, because I've talked to a lot of coaches, and it seemed like a lot of coaches, their magic number is 10, preferably nine.
Yeah, I don't like nine. Never did. I mean, one year I had 13, and we managed. Mm-hmm. It's tough. Because if a couple kids are missing, you're already down to eight if you have 10.
Right.
You know, even 11, I wouldn't mind 11. I know when it gets 12, it's playing time. We only play 40 minutes, mm-hmm. you know, and I know we only have 4 minutes stop time each quarter. So I know it's tough. But, you know, I'd rather have more, because you're always missing one or two.
Right, right.
You know, it's just life's different than it was 20 years ago or even 10. I mean, now it's kids are so busy. Kids have to work. You know, kids got to babysit now. Mm-hmm. It's just it's a much, much tougher world now than it was 30 years ago. You know, when kids just were kids. They didn't have to work. They didn't have to. You know, they just wanted to play. So, and I know it's tough.
Well, Steve, this has always been the quickest 30 minutes of the season. So once again,
thank you,
Steve
man.
Wright, thank you for coming out tonight. Steve Wright, folks, head coach of the defending Neighborhood League champs, the Bullets. Until next time, just like to say, buenas noches, hoochas cooches. I came in peace. I leave with love. This is for the red, the black, and the green. And I'll be seeing you at the games.
Moses Malone, I like slam dunks, taking it to the hoop. My favorite play is